Hello there. It's another beautiful day and I'm so delighted to be here with you. My name is Kemi Tony Akinwumi. Welcome to Making Marriage Work. And I want to believe you are learning a lot from all the series that we keep sharing. Thank you so much for the likes and the comments. And so today again, we have another guest, someone you've seen before actually, Mr. Ajibade, a professional counselor. Welcome to the show, sir.
Thank you so much.
Thank you so much for being here. And so today again, we are looking at a very sensitive topic that I know you would like to hear and learn from. So today, sir, we'll be looking at changes in body image as it relates to sexual satisfaction in marriage. I know that you are an elderly person, you've been married 33 years, and that's a long time to be married. And so I know a lot has happened in your marriage over time. You were not like this 33 years ago when you got married. You were younger, you had the vibes and all of that. So, but we want to look at how does one's body image, you know, and growth, how does it affect sex in marriage? What are the challenges and what are the things couple, you know, have to adjust to as they grow older in marriage?
Thank you so much. This is an interesting topic. Definitely, as you have linked it to my own experience. Yes, when people start out in marriage, usually in their late 20s or early 30s, is a time of strength, of vigor, a time where you can jump up and down, you feel alive.
Right.
But as you said, as time goes on, first of all, for the woman, when she starts having children, for a lot of women, they tend to add weight, to increase in size. And then, even for the man, some men also, as time goes on, in their 40s, when resources have come and money has come, they tend to, some of them can increase, develop pot belly. So, both the man and the woman, the changes come in their body as they progress in marriage. Now, talking about sexual satisfaction, a little part of marriage, because the strength and the vigor is there, usually you don't have much problems. But as time goes on, in their 40s and as they approach 50s, you find that some men may have some sexual issues, maybe like erectile dysfunction, and even the woman also, you know, especially when, what do you call that,
begins
menopause. Menopause begins to set in, the urge for sex and the desire for sex begins to fluctuate. So it's important to understand at that time and to manage it. What you do at that time is to manage. So a counselor will teach coping mechanism at that period. Because it's not a time where you run away. If you run away, it doesn't really solve any problem.
Because you have seen that some people want to run away, actually.
Some people actually want to run
away. Okay, say for instance, it's normal that a woman would go through pregnancy and her body will change.
Definitely.
At least majority of women, you know, they had weight, they have, you know, their bellies are they have bigger, you know, tummy. Some of them are running out of shape. Some of them are no longer as beautiful, as attractive, you know, as they used to be. Which means every woman also knows that there are a lot of physical, you know,
changes,
upgrades I need to begin to do to still maintain my attraction to my partner. But we have some partners who are not very sensitive. That the moment their wife looks different in their words, in their attitudes, in their body language, and even in their expression to their partner, they even belittle and demean, you know, their partner because of their body, the changes in their body. But is that being fair? Because this is nature. She became a mother and she has to change. Right?
That's really not fair. I think it has to do with a lot of expectations that are really out of reality. Because you should expect, just as you have a child, when the child is 2 years, there's a height, there's a way the child will look. By the time the child is 6 years, you should not expect that child to still look like a 2-year-old. It's the same thing with a woman.
Right.
The same thing, even the man himself.
The man.
There's changes happen. So, living with this reality that, yes, my wife when I married her at 26, now she's 35. The truth is that no matter how much young a person looks, the age is still the same. Still if the you same. See somebody who's 40 years, he may look like a 20-year-old, but he's still 40 years. So it's important to live with the reality. And rather than create tension at home, there's a way to go
around. So share some of those coping mechanisms that you mentioned earlier for older you know, couples in their 40s. Yes. How can they still have a vibrant, a beautiful sexual experience and not allowing their age or their body changes to affect what happens in the other room?
Thank you. One of the ways is to manage your expectations. When you are expecting that the way your sexual life was 1-2 years after marriage, you expect it to be the same thing after 25 years. That is a wrong
Unrealistic expectations.
So manage the expectations. Accept the reality of what is happening at this time. So it helps in approaching various other coping mechanisms. Like, at that time, there's no way your sexual life can be as vibrant as it used to be. What some men do is that at that time, they begin to use sexual enhancers.
Lots of aphrodisias.
Aphrodisias. And that also can contribute to a lot of health problems.
Health problems.
So be realistic in your expectations.
No matter how much Viagra or aphrodisia you want to take, it cannot reverse your age.
It cannot. And that will mean that maybe the frequency of sexual interaction will not be properly managed, knowing your body. You properly manage it.
If you're doing every day before, maybe it has to be once a week or once in two weeks.
And then, at that age, really, say at 25 years after 25 years after marriage, there should be a better way to create, to manage the bond between a couple, rather than just sex.
Depending on sex.
So you don't have to depend on sex.
Right.
Because at that time you have children, even if it is a home where there's no child, both of you, look at the number of years you have lived together. I share with those who are very close to me that I've been married for 33 years. I'm 60 years old, which means I've spent 50% of my life with my wife.
Right.
Over 50% of my life. And that is why it's important to know that you get to spend longer time with your spouse, even than the children, even than your parents. So this is really the time that you need to be happy. So find things that you do together that will create a bond.
The friendship, the love, the interaction.
Because at that time, there's a lot of visual appeal that you gain from your spouse. Beyond sexual interaction, engagement. So you see yourself, you are happy, you know, you talk with her, you have various things to share together about your life experiences. And at that time, you have more value to give to your children, to your grandchildren, to people around you. Because people look at you, they want to learn from your experience. So you should have good things that you share with them. So look for other things that you can do together that will bring a bond. Should I ask what I do in my home?
It would be nice to hear from you.
Okay, what I do is that in the morning with my wife, we take a walk.
Amazing.
We take a walk, make like 2-3 kilometers every morning. And when we are walking together, I usually have something that I'm playing. We have this Bluetooth earpiece. So she uses one. I use the other. And we take a walk in our environment. And that's the time in the morning we share some stories or what has happened. So by the time we have gone like that, we come back at home. We take our breakfast. I discovered that it creates a lot of bond. And if you have something that we look forward to. So at night you will say, I want to sleep early so that I don't want to miss the early morning walk. So find a lot of things that we do together to share together to maintain the bond. The frequency of the sexual engagement may be low, but there are other things that bring you together. Yes, I can compliment for that.
So thank you so much for sharing your experience. But have you had cases, I know you're also a counselor, have you had cases of older couples coming in and talking about, you know, enhancing their sexual life, either with medication or toys, or have you had experiences like that? And how were you able to handle it?
Yes, I've had couples who have been married for 27 years and they start having issues in their marriage, and mainly because the sexual engagement is now very low, and one of them wants it more frequently. The other one says, the woman says, what is it again? We are not having kids again. So let's space it.
But that would also be a wrong way to look at it. Yes. Because sex is not just for procreation.
Exactly.
There are other benefits one can derive from.
So the foundation of the counseling is to make the woman understand that sex is not just for procreation.
Yes.
But you know, people who have grown up in an environment where some mindset have been set with which they approach marriage.
Right.
So, but we first have to deal with that and educate them that, no, this is how to go about it, that you have to make sure that it is constant as often as both of you find it convenient. Yes, the issue of sexual enhancers, there have been cases of people who have been using it. But for me, I'm reluctant to, I'd rather make them understand their body system in a natural way. I rather advise them to take natural food, you know, take fruits, take something that can...
Vitamins
that
eat
will
healthy.
Help them. Yes, eat healthy, live healthy,
exercise.
Do exercise. Rather than depending on
medication.
Because I've seen cases where because of using medication, it becomes another health challenge.
Yes.
The woman
now
has high blood pressure, and bringing it down is costing so much. I've seen a man also that develops some other health complications. So I rather advise them along that line. Live right, eat healthy, do exercise, and in that case, and then space your interaction.
Right.
Find some other fun to share
together.
So in that case,
which means friendship is actually what holds a marriage after a long time, not sex.
Not sex.
So speaking to younger couples or newlyweds or someone even looking forward to marriage, and the focus is, oh, I'm going to have sex, I'm going to, which means that at a point, it will no longer be
Be
sex. So they should actually build friendship into their marriage, because friendship is more important than sex. Because when friendship is stable, when they have a good friend, you know, friendship, when their interaction is beautiful, when their engagement, you know, is peaceful, they can then manage the sexual expectation. Because from what you've said about the couple, you know, having issues, if their expectation is properly managed to say that this person cannot deliver more than this, and our friendship is still okay, it will have been easier to manage, you know, the sexual desires, knowing that we have had great times in the past. Let's look at memories. Let's talk to our children. Let's invest in others. Let's enjoy our life. And we then space, you know, our sexual engagement. If it's once a week, you know, or few times during the week. But lastly, I would like you to just speak to someone out there who is going through, you know, some issues in their marriage or in their sexual life as a result of their physical look. Because no doubt, people can really, really worry when their physical appearance is not so much attractive to their partner. What would you say to such a man or a woman?
Yes, you find men who expect that 10, 15, 20 years after marriage, they still expect their wives to look the way she looked when they got married. That's also a wrong expectation. So first of all, manage your expectation. Sometimes it's also the man, the woman says, you are beginning to have bald head. You didn't have bald head when we got married. So it works both ways. So the first thing is that face the reality of life, manage your expectations. You should expect that at this age, when a woman is 45, she's not 25.
Right.
Don't expect her at 45 to behave like a 25-year-old lady. So manage your expectations. Then if it is something that has to do with your sexual engagement, know that even if you are vibrant, if the other person is not vibrant, there's still a way to manage it. You still have to manage it. It does not mean that you now begin to mess around and you create problem in the home. So manage it. Some of them may need to get some counseling.
Right.
So if they need to get counseling, then
reach out
for counseling.